Hey, Sashan, what is going on? Tim Kaine talking about class and skill-based when it comes to RPGs. Either tabletop, mostly it's computer RPGs that he's talking about. The age-old question. I mean, I've been talking about this for what? 4 decades now. It's kind of a big deal. Anyway, two old farts talking about the age-old things.
Hi everyone, it's me, Tim, and today I want to talk about class versus skill-based role-playing games. I've read a lot of discussion online about this for years. Some people think classes are the way to go, they're original.
There's a lot of people that think that. It's like when Loki says, I have an army.
They're how things were done a long time ago. They're tried and true and tested. I've heard other people say, no, skills are the way to go. They're the best. They're the new wave. Even
BRP, skill-based. I might have that book somewhere, the 30th anniversary one. Is that what it was? Guys, you buy a book, right? You put it in a box, you move a few times, you rebuy the book thinking, where's my book? You rebuy it, now you have two copies of it. One book is original and one is 30 years newer. Like where it happened? It seems like only a year has gone by.
even though they've been around for 20 years. I think that the real answer, of course, is a little one, a little the other. So what I wanted to do.
Depends on what you're doing. I mean, do you want to do the conversions when you get a module for your RPG, or do you just want to use it as is? What RPG are you using? What are your friends? What's fun at your table? That nonsense. As long as everyone's having fun.
Is talk about the pros and cons of class-based systems because I realized every pro of class is a con of skill and vice versa. So let's talk about why designers and players even like class-based RPGs. So first off, classes.
Archetypes. You always got the guy who he likes his archetypes. He likes his tropes.
Provide a nice bundle of skills and feats and other things.
Templates. I mean, Traveler has them too. They call them careers. But within the careers, you're still doing skill base, which is cool. Skyrim's the same way. Skyrim's got the class, but basically it's race. Race is class, class is race. As you're making your character, you're dealing with the same skills. Everyone has, all the races have the same skills. Just the class controls your attributes for the most part. And maybe how fast you can learn a skill. I mean, my argument already is going to be get rid of classes, use skill base, and you still have attributes, still have your attributes based on race. They're just not classes as though. Class is too cookie cutter. Cookie cutter, creepy crawler sets, color forms. What was it? Spirograph. They're all cookie cutter. This, You buy this toy, this is what it makes, this is only what it can make. Skill-based has more variety. Now you're kind of limited by the skills in your game. You don't want a game that's got like 200 skills in it. You also don't want a game that only has 12, 20 skills. That's terrible. Then you don't want to have anyway, let's listen to what he says.
It's the designer's way of saying, hey, I've already pre-picked a bunch of things that work well together and have been designed together and balanced together. So when you pick a fighter class, it's good for fighting. When you pick a wizard class,
Yeah, you basically, here's your build, here's your character build. Have at it.
It's good for doing magic. When you pick a rogue class, it's good for stealing. It just, these things come with, luckily, with a good kind of baggage that tell you how to play that class. Plus, at least for fantasy games, there are so many tropes that exist for fantasy,
Yep.
and I'll talk about that in a bit, that classes being one of them is just makes it very easy to know what you're getting, which
Yep.
gives me my second advantage of class-based systems. They're very easy to understand.
Yep.
For you, the player, who is coming to a new system.
It's almost dumbed down to a point. If you can read a book, you can play an RPG.
When you see, oh, there's a fighter, I have an idea of what he's going to do. Oh, there's a rogue, I have an idea what he's going to do. And it's not just for you, the player, playing that character. If you're playing in a party, it's very easy for them to understand what you're going to do and what your role in the party is going to be. If you're playing a fighter type,
Gonna play Gauntlet. We're gonna play Gauntlet tonight. Bring your paper and pencils.
you're going to tank. You're the one who's expected to wade forth and attack that monster. If you're playing a wizard, you're probably going to hang back and shoot spells. Yeah.
To me, it's boring as fuck to role play a cartoon character. It's just dumb.
There are two classes, and yeah, there are some classes that hybridize those two things. But in general, people know what those roles are. Which brings me to the third reason class-based systems are good, is when you first start a class-based RPG, it is very easy for you to pick a character. Not
And that's usually the game system you're going to use for life, the one you learned on, for most people, in general. Most people still cling to the first RPG they ever played.
only are they easy to understand and all the skills are bundled, it just makes it easier for you to pick one because there aren't hundreds of choices. There's usually 6, 10, maybe 15. That's a lot easier to pick than looking at lists of hundreds of.
GURPS. GURPS. Even GURPS light.
Skills and wondering, gee, I wonder which one of these are going to be used in this campaign. There was a character that a friend of mine made when I ran a GURPS campaign.
Yeah, if you don't role play your character, it's really hard to make a GURPS character. Because you're looking at all the skills and all the traits and all the active powers and everything, you're like, holy crap. What is, I can be anything I want. And a lazy player will just have a rough time at making a character. They don't have focus. You have to have focus what your character is going to be. And then you look at what your character would have, would need, that kind of thing. Then you start mucking around with the rules. You're like, oh, here's a disadvantage. Okay, so now my character's blind. Oh, now my character's crippled. Oh, now my character's mentally retarded. Oh, now my character is, just so you can get what? So you can role play the most awesome powered Metal mesh organically immutable to anything, immortal, all that kind of nonsense.
And she put most of her points into savoir-faire.
No, put your luck. Okay. Put all your points in luck. That's it. And that's on top of your luck roll. So everything good happens after that.
Because she thought of her character as this uptown elegant lady. And of course, when combat broke out, she was like, "Can I savoir-faire them?" And I asked her exactly what she meant by that. I said, "If you can role-play it, I'll let you roll."
Exactly.
And it was hard to come on, like someone's shooting at you with a gun, and you're like, that's a really low-class way of acting, don't you think? I'm like,
No.
not sure what you're trying to get
No,
to happen with
you
that.
don't want to be cliche about it. Okay, Joss Whedon probably come up with a cool scene for that.
Guy with the gun. But it just kind of emphasizes the point of if she had had a few
Right,
clap.
okay, it depends on how the guy or whoever's shooting role played their shooting first. We need all the details to know how it's going to play out.
Classes to pick from, that would have been a lot easier, but there were literally in GURPS hundreds of skills. She had no idea what was going to happen. Similar to this, once you're playing the
Yeah, you're
game,
like, I made my character, and then you start playing, and everyone else the game is a total hobo serial killer. It's like, what? No. It's like you make a character without even finding out what the other players are gonna make.
and you level up. It's easy to level a class because they usually come with
Charts.
a list of skills that they're allowed to buy and feats they can advance, and those are often restricted by level, or
Yeah.
some of them, like there are skills that are marked as specifically for that class, so spending a point in them is worth more than if you buy an off-class skill. So you're already guided on how to level up this
Yeah,
character.
spoon
Where
fed.
in a
Spoon
skill-based
fed.
system, who knows? And then similar to that, as you adventure and find items in a class-based system, it's really easy to decide who gets the items. Sometimes items are restricted to a class.
Yep.
Like something will drop and they said, "This is wizard only," or "This is thief only." Great. We only have one in the party. They get it. But like if a sword drops, you're probably going to give that to the fighter. Maybe the cleric can't even use it. Or the rogue may want it, but if the fighter is currently doesn't have a magic weapon and it's a magic sword, you probably want to give it to the fighter first. Then if another magic weapon drops, you can give that to the rogue. And of course, the wizard and the cleric don't care about those things. So classes make it very easy to just.
So the characters just become garbage haulers. Yeah. Just carry what you would normally carry. You don't have to own all the things in the game.
Distribute items among the party. And then the last big reason class-based systems are popular have nothing to do with players, but everything to do with the designers. It is much, much, much easier to balance a class-based system.
Yeah, I'm against balance. I'm against any kind of game balance. Game balance is for pussies. That's what Tetris is for.
Because there's only, like I said, a few classes you can buy. It's e and those come with pre-bundled feats and skills. It's very easy to balance classes against each other, so no one class is much, much better than another class. In particular situations, yeah.
StarCraft. Rock, paper, scissors.
There will be one class that's a lot better than another class. One-on-one fight with an orc, I'd rather be a fighter than a wizard. One-on-one fight with an orc face to face, of course you don't want to be a wizard. Maybe if they start at a distance and you have time to get a spell off, maybe. But the advantages and disadvantages of those classes have already been examined by the designer or the design team and balanced out. That's almost impossible to do if you have hundreds of skills. There will always be some skills that are so situational that somebody who buys up them is just not going to be good in any other situation, which kind of brings me to the downside of classes. When you play a class-based RPG, you kind of have to know how you want to play right away, because that's there's only so many classes, and they're very limited on what they can do.
Yep.
You want to cast spells? Don't take a fighter. You want to wade into battle? You probably don't want to be.
Well, if you want to use magic and you're a fighter, use a sword that has magic powers. Like He-Man.
If the party really needs a healer, that pretty much restricts what that class is going to be. You basically have to decide that. If you're making a party and you want a healer, someone's got to play it.
Boring game this sounds like already. You're telling me millions of people have bought this game?
Someone's got to take that class. Which brings me to the second negative for class-based systems, which is you don't get to play how you want. You may have this really cool idea in your head, but it doesn't really fit with the existing classes. Let's say you're playing D&D and you want to be Indiana.
Heck, it doesn't even fit the setting. This is what happens. Let's say even if you do buy an Indiana Jones game and you invite your players over, guess what happens? Your players will play the fucking game like it's D&D. So you're like, okay, let's try Call of Cthulhu. I'm gonna have my friends come over. We're gonna play Call of Cthulhu. Guess what happens? They all fucking play it like it's D&D. D&D just sucks. It just sucks.
Indiana Jones, which means you have a gun and
a whip. Throw me the whip.
And archaeology skill.
And you have an
there's
idol.
Really no good class that covers that. You could probably be a fighter, you know, but that comes with a whole bunch of things that aren't Indiana Jones, and you just have to ignore them. You could be a rogue, but that also comes with a bunch of skills that you're never going to use, or because they're there and probably good, maybe you will use them, but now your character of Indiana Jones isn't really acting like Indiana Jones. The game is telling you how to act, not your conception. And that's a problem with class-based games, is those the wonderful tropes that make it very easy to pick and level up a class also kind of define how they're going to play them to a big extent. It doesn't determine your personality.
Have you mentioned roleplay yet? We're waiting for the word roleplay to happen.
Or your background, but I'm talking about, like, in terms of actions, it's kind of predefined what you're going to do. And then the other thing about class systems, which is a negative, is you can't experience extreme characters. The advantage I talked about all the classes being balanced by a designer, that's great if that's what you want, is balance. I love extreme characters. I love playing a character where I put a ton of points into a few things. I had a GURPS character once that I gave an 18 dexterity to. That took almost all my points. So the few points I had left over, I think I got him, he had a rapier and he had the skill in that. So he was good at stabbing people and parrying. But if something got by his parry, he tended to go down.
Yep.
And his attacks didn't do much damage because he wasn't very strong, but he would almost always hit. And... So he'd kind of like whittle down enemies. It was an extreme character and really cool. You may not be able to make that in all class-based systems. My friend Savoir Faire character certainly couldn't be made in most class-based systems. So everything I just said about classes that are pros are cons in skills. It's you in skill-based systems. You don't have bundled skills. They're not necessarily easy to understand for a starting person. It's not easy for you to join a group and them to understand exactly what you can do. It's hard to pick what skills you want out of the hundreds of skills. When you level up, you're faced with that decision again. Do you want to continue up the skills you already have? Or do you want to pick a new skill from the hundreds of skills that are available? And there's no guarantee that the selection of skills you pick will be balanced by...
Yeah, there's no guarantee that you even get to use... I mean, you're not going to use all the skills in one game session. The situation might not ever come up. You have an archaeology skill, but archaeology may never even come up. 'Cause you're in a tavern, you know, that kind of nonsense.
the designer in that game. Or even if he tried to, who knows, like in GURPS where the setting can be wildly different, Savoir Faire would be great in a city-based campaign, really bad in a dungeon adventuring campaign. So I think it requires a lot of intervention from the GM when you have skill-based systems, if you want that. The cons of class-based are the pros of skill. You have an idea in your head, you can play that exact character exactly how you want, with the skills you want, even if they're really extreme and they don't fit any trope for the setting you're playing. So I like that. In some ways, everything I just described.
Yeah, I'll have a player say, you know, they'll tell me they want to play a certain kind of character. I have them write down what skills, without looking at the book, just have them email me the character with a list of skills they think the character should have. I'll make a template. I'll make a traveler career template for that player. And they can generate that character using the template. It's got the skills. It's got the life events. It's got the mishap tables that would happen with that character. It's a thing of beauty. The skill-based.
About class versus skill, you can say about fantasy versus sci-fi settings. The advantage that fantasy settings have is because all these tropes exist, the character knows, the player knows what a vampire is. Now, yeah, Twilight vampire is very different than a masquerade vampire, but in general, it's this blood-sucking spirit, you know, super.
And total party skills vampires are different from both of those.
Supernatural creature. But when you go to play sci-fi, that is incredibly setting specific. What's a Darlock? Do you even know? Do you even know where that's from without having to Google it? I thought it was Doctor Who. It's not. Oh, but what's a Reaper? Oh, wait, that is Doctor Who. No, it's not. It's XCOM. No, it's not. It's Mass Effect. It's all of them. And those Reapers are three wildly different.
Yeah, they're just using the same name.
So similar to where fantasy and sci-fi have that disparity. So do
I want to say Firefly has Reavers in it. And so does Skyrim. You know, totally different things.
Class and skill-based. And you have to overcome. You have to teach the player more in a skill-based system.
Well, before you start the game, you decide what genre, what setting you're going to do. You know, find out from the players what books they've read, movies they've seen, whatever, TV shows, something. So you have an idea of what the universe is going to, how the universe works, what you do in the universe. So the players know what kind of characters they're going to make. You don't just say, oh, I'm going to run a sci-fi session. Oh, everyone, you know, four players sign up and four players have totally different ideas of what sci-fi is. Yeah, don't do that.
Now, if you look at all my games, I went skill-based for Fallout and Arcanum, two of my first RPGs, and then Outer Worlds, my latest RPG. But then in the middle there, I went class-based for Temple, for Vampire Bloodlines, for South Park, for Pillars, for Tyranny. So you may be trying to decide, well, do you like class-based, Tim, or do you like skill-based? It sounds like you liked you like skill-based, but then you went into class-based, and then you changed your mind recently.
Depends on the game document. Back in the day, I did class-based computer games, because that's what there was. The minute computers had more RAM and I started seeing the skill-based stuff happening, that was the end of that. That was the end of class-based for me, as far as computer goes.
Not really. Here's my rule. I prefer a class-based RPG if it's a multiplayer game or it's a single-player game where the player makes a party of characters. I like how classes define the roles, help make those characters more distinct. And if it's a multiplayer game, help convey to the other.
You're basically making NPCs when you're making a class character. You want your character to fit with the NPCs in the game. That's it.
Players, what role you'll be fulfilling. For single player and single character RPGs, I like going skill based. I don't like that restriction of classes. If you want to make some extreme.
Yeah, in skill based games, you got the NPCs, and then there's you. You're not a character cloned from one of the NPCs in the game. You're in addition to the NPCs in the game.
Character and play. I almost encourage that. It's fun to see if you can do that. GURPS had a name for mages who only took one spell but put all their points in it. Johnny One Spell. Like, you take a fire spell and all you can do is burn things, but wow, can you burn things. It's really bad when you encounter a fire elemental, which is immune to fire. But for everything else, it's awesome. So, and that's just something that you have to learn when you play. So, that's kind of the role I use. Multiplayer and party-based games, classes, single player, single character game, skill. If push came to shove and you gave me a bag of money, I'm going to pick single player, single character so I can go skill-based. It's on my teeter-totter, I'm a little more skill-oriented than class. But that doesn't mean I don't understand why class-based design is good and what it's used for.
Exactly. What it's used for.
Okay, I think that's a lot of thoughts on class versus skill. I'm sure you have your own thoughts. I just kind of wanted to get it all down. It's come up a few times in comments, and it was on my list of topics to talk about anyway.
What the heck? He's done? How long did I... Only half an hour almost. I thought I was going to be talking for an hour and a half on this topic. This was a short video.